We set up a production team in London, Chris Lycett in charge with producer Fergus Dudley and studio manager Brian Thompson to handle the incoming material. When it came near to the start date, they actually left 4 days early as Jonathan came to me and said, "Johnny, there's a container ship leaving from Barry Island on Friday for the West Indies and we need to be on it." I agreed they could go before the roadshow tour started, but it was within the principle because that too set off for Northern Ireland on the same day. We organised a huge public send-off for Jonathan and Simon in front of Broadcasting House on June the 30th. It was a pretty impressive sight because they were staggering under the most enormous load of equipment, which included their so-called lightweight satellite uplink dish. This piece of kit, together with a portable generator, weighed around 90 kilos without their personal luggage. They needed to be fit, and I was pleased to hear they had been undergoing some personal fitness training before they set off. The difficulty of sustaining the interest in the broadcast was a potential problem. When you're on a container ship for 10 days, what else can you do after you've talked to various members of the crew and described the sea? They solved this with the help from Fergus Dudley in London. He set up an assortment of star interviews. Thus we had Lisa Minnelli sitting in Egton House in London, being interviewed by Simon Bates on a ship thousands of miles away. As she said afterwards, "That was one of the most bizarre interviews of my life." The project caught the imagination of the listeners, not just through the radio broadcast, but also through the TV reports they made on children's television. There was a programme called Up to You.